Tonight at 6, a story you will see only here on 2. Lots of people lost income or lost their jobs during this pandemic, but not one former state lawmaker.
Even though he was reassigned to manual labor, he got to keep his nearly six-figure salary. Investigative reporter Steve Brown has our Two on Your Side original.
Niagara Falls State Park is a beautiful place. Keeping it beautiful takes a dedicated team of workers to keep the place spruced up and picked up. And surprisingly, the effort includes former State Assemblyman John Serretta, who, by the way, has a salary a lot higher than any maintenance worker we've ever heard of. We got wind of this from a tipster who sent us this email. Hi, Steve. With the nicer weather, I've been taking more frequent walks around Niagara Falls State Park, and I've been seeing former New York State Assemblyman John Serretta walking around the park with an orange bucket and grabbers picking up litter. The tipster also sent this picture, a blurry shot of somebody standing next to a vehicle with an orange bucket on the ground. Not clear enough to confirm the tipster's story. We knew the former three-term member of the state assembly works for the state parks department, but not with an assignment that would seemingly include maintenance. Serretta's job with State Parks is leading the Kids Connect program for the western region of the state. That's a state subsidy program to encourage schools to take more field trips to state parks and historical sites. Last year, when COVID hit and the field trip stopped, well, Serretta picked up additional duties. In a brief statement, the state park spokesman confirmed our tipster's story, telling Two on Your Side, Serretta is currently splitting his time working with schools and helping maintain the park. So Serretta, a former state assembly member, is picking up trash at Niagara Falls State Park. Did I mention that Serretta worked for state parks before he was in the assembly? He was a member of the Niagara Region Environmental Education Team out of the Discovery Center. Serretta's last full year in that job with the Parks Department was the same year he was first elected to the assembly in 2010. According to the website See Through New York, operated by the fiscally conservative watchdog group Empire Center, Serretta was paid just under $35,000 that year. After 6 years in the assembly, Serretta returns, new title, more than twice his old salary. And it grew and grew to $97,000 plus last year. Kind of expensive for a guy whose duties include picking up trash at a state park. Now, we left messages with Serretta because we wanted to talk to him about this, but we got no response until we got a message from a Parks Department press person. It was from Serretta, who touted his work with the field trips. Over the 3 years I ran the outreach, the Niagara region led the way in volume of field trips that took place both in the region and for schools in Western New York that became aware of the program because of my work. About all this, we spoke with the man who knocked Serretta out of the state assembly.
And I think it's time that we start looking at what is actually happening in government.
Angelo Morinello said nice things about Serretta and the job he was doing on the field trips, but added this.
There is no accountability in government. No one analyzes and looks at expenditures for the benefit of the taxpayers. We have multiple programs that have no accountability. Money is thrown at them. We don't know what they're doing.
And we only know about this story because someone tipped us off. Now, this situation with Serretta will come to an end soon. He's retiring June 30th. He's already applied for his pension, and the state comptroller's office says it hasn't calculated yet how much he will get. But our back of the envelope math suggests it'll be in the neighborhood of $94,000 annually. At Niagara Falls State Park, Steve Brown, Channel 2 News.